Hey guys, and welcome back. So this is part one of three. We're going to be creating a augmented reality water sensor, also known as the Thirsty Plant project. So what this entails is that we're going to have a plant. We're going to insert a water sensor. That water sensor will output data to the cloud via Internet of Things. And from that cloud, it will retrieve the data to Unity and overlay the water level in augmented reality on our plant. So it's quite a really cool project. So what we're going to cover in this lecture and this video, we're going to start off with getting the visualization correct. So we're going to create a cube, assuming that we have a cube shaped pot plant, and then we're going to add a water texture to it. So what this cube represents is the level of the water within our pot plant. Then we're going to add a pivot and scale to it. And just to make sure that you understand what's going on, we're going to add a slider to control that variable. Now this variable will interface to the variable that we receive from the cloud, and that is our water level. So let's get started on getting our visualization. Okay, to get started, start a new project. So in the last video, what we did was we created our Internet of Things. And this is where we got data from our particle photon and uploaded it to the cloud. And from the cloud, we got it into Unity. So go ahead and say click File, New Scene, and create a cube. Now we'll use this cube to represent our water model or water level. Now go over to the GitHub repository and download a package, Unity package called EasyWater, and drag it into your assets folder. Click import. Now once it is imported, click on Easy Water, and we're going to drag this texture onto our cube. If you click this button over here, you can visualize the script in action. If you click play, you can view the cube from afar. Now that's a little bit too far for us, so let's just move our camera a bit closer. Click play, and that looks quite beautiful, but let's change the color to something a little bit more blue. So let's go over to our Easy Water shader, and this color will look for a nice blue tint, something a little bit more realistic and blue. I think this color looks good. If you want to get the exact color, just copy this hex code. Now instead of having a boring cube to show the level, we have this water texture showing us a very nice representation of our water level. Save your scene, and we're going to call this water level representation or rep. Now what we need to do is, before we can scale our object, we first need to add a pivot. So right click, and create empty or game object, and we can see it over there. We can bring it out, but it vanishes quite a lot. Okay, so we're going to import two scripts. One is gizmo.cs and scale.cs. Let's create a new folder within assets and call it scripts over here, and we're going to import our scripts into this folder. Your game object that you have over here, you can rename that to cube underscore pivot, which is over here. And we're going to drag on our gizmo onto our cube pivot. Now what this gizmo does is that it adds a sphere, a white sphere around our game object. Open the script up in MonoDevelop and you can see what is happening. So we've got two variables, which is gizmo size and gizmo color. This will just be a default value of 0.75. We've got gizmo color, which we assigned yellow to it. And then we have our function, which is built into the Unity libraries, which is called onDrawGizmos. So we're taking our gizmo color, which is yellow, and assigning it to gizmos.color, and then to draw the white sphere at certain position with the certain size that we have assigned it to. Quite simple. Now going back to our cube pivot, we're going to change the color to something a little bit bright, and we're going to decrease the size just so we can visualize it a bit more easy. Now you can move it, try and align it to one of the vertices. You can try Ctrl and V to do that, and that should be fine. Now what I want you to do is to take cube and make it a child of the cube pivot. This is so when we rotate it, it will rotate around the pivot as opposed to the center of the object. So as you can see, if we make the scale, we can increase or decrease the scale and it will only increase on one side. Now to avoid this overlapping, try and make sure that your pivot is exactly on the vertex. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to add a script called scale. This will control the scale of our cube. So go to cube pivot and drag on the scale script. And if you click play, you'll see the size as 5, which goes off our screen. If you make that 1, you'll see the cube a bit more smaller. Let's take a look at what the script is doing. So we start off with a variable and a size with a default of 5. And we create a temporary vector called temp. We don't do anything in initialization. We can perform our resizing in the update function. So what we do is we get transform.localScale. So we get the scale and save it into temp, which is our vector that we declared. And then we assign the size variable into that vector, which is on the x-axis only. And then we update our local scale and transform our game object or cube by using the temp variable. Now this function over here called adjustSize takes in an argument called new size, and this is of type float. And when we get a variable called new size, that will update our size, and hence it will update our temp vector. This function over here is what we're going to be using when we add our slider to control the size of our cube in real time. Okay, so what you can do is you can go ahead and play around with the size just to make sure that you are able to adjust the size of your water body. Also move your main camera back just so you can visualize the size a bit better. Okay, and now what we're gonna do is just like before, under render mode, go to world space so we can edit the size of our canvas. Set the position vectors to 0, 0, 0. I'm just going to speed up this part of the video so it's not so monotonous. And now over here, what we're going to do is we're going to add in a slider. Let's just make it a little bit bigger also. Now when adjusting your slider, make sure it is visible to the main camera. Now to change the level of the water with our slider, you have to go to slide over here and under on value change, click plus. Click on this round object over here and we want to adjust our cube pivot. Under no function, go to scale and then we're going to go to our function called adjust size. It's easy as that. Go to play and let's see if this works. So that's quite cool. By moving the slider, we can easily adjust the level of the water. Now for our application, we are not going to be using the slider, but rather a level of the water which will be obtained from our particle photon via the cloud. So in part 2, what we're going to do is we're going to interface our water level sensor to our particle photon. We're going to hook up those circuits and then the variables that we obtain from our sensor are going to be sent to the cloud and published to the particle photon console, and then we're going to try and obtain that data via Unity. In the third lecture or third part of this series, we're going to be integrating our water level to our particle photon water level variable. Okay, so that is it from me. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And if you'd like to see more videos or more content from me, please click the bell icon right below this video. This will make sure that you receive a notification every time I release a new video. Okay, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next lecture.